So here, what we understand in the first paragraph is nature and business of scope. We see many people do a different kind of jobs, different kind of work to earn money so that they can satisfy their needs and necessities. We see our parents, our relatives, our neighbors going for different kind of works. They have different schedule of working. Some go in the morning, some go in the afternoon, some go in the evening, and some go in the night. So in business studies, we are going to study what kind of businesses are there in this world and how we get through these businesses. Now in this chapter, what we are going to study is, let's understand the objectives now. After studying this lesson, you will be able to define human activities, distinguish between economic and non-economic activities. Define the term business. Identify various characteristics of business. Explain the objectives of business. Explain the social responsibility of business. And explain the types, causes and effects of pollution and role of business to reduce environmental pollution. Now let us understand the human activities. Activities which human beings undertake are known as a human activities. We can divide these activities into two categories, economic activities and non-economic activities. So whatever work we take it as a responsibility can be called as human activities. Now this human activities is further divided into two categories. First category is economic activities and the other category is non-economic activities. So let us read it in detail. Economic activities. Activities which are performed with an objective to earn money are known as economic activities. For example, farmers grow crops to sell them, a factory or office employs work and get wages or salaries. A business person earns profit through buying and selling of goods and services. These activities are economic activities. So your economic activities is explained as an activity which is being done to earn money. Like we see farmers, they grow crops and sell them and earn money. In factories and offices, we see people working over there and get their salaries. A business person gets into a business and earns profits by selling his goods and services to the people. These are called economic activities. Now let us see what is non-economic activities. Activities which are not performed to earn money but to get some satisfaction are called non-economic activities. These activities are performed to discharge social obligation or for physical fitness or for recreation, etc. People visiting places of worship, providing relief to the victims of flood and earthquake, engaging in sports activities, gardening, listening to radio or watching television are few examples of non-economic activities. Non-economic activities are further explained as any work which is being done for their happiness. In the sense, the person who feels happy, relaxed by doing some work for himself is a non-economic activity, like watching movie, going for some worship places like temples and some of the religious places where they visit, or providing some relief to the victims of flood and earthquake, where they go and help them without any sort of expectations of getting money. But they do that because they feel happy helping others. Participating in some sports activities, watching television, listening to music. These are some social activities what a person is happy doing for himself. So these activities are called as non-economic activities. in this chart we see difference between economic and non-economic activities. Basic economic activities, non-economic activities. Basis is purpose. In economic activities it is earning motive. In non-economic, social and psychological motive. Outcome, lead to creation of wealth and asset, lead to satisfaction and happiness. Expectations, people expect profits and or money income. People don't expect profits or money income. Consideration, they are guided by rational consideration as they involve the use of scarce economic resources such as land, labor, capital, etc. They are motivated by emotional and sentimental reasons. Non-economic consideration is involved. So this is the basic explanation, or you can call it as a basic difference between economic and non-economic activities of a human. So basis of this distinction is considered as purpose, outcome, expectation and consideration. So here the basic purpose is to earn money in economic activities. Here they will get social and psychological satisfaction. Outcome, lead to creation of wealth and assets, lead to satisfaction and happiness. So on, it has been described further as you can refer it. Now further let us study types of economic activities. We know that economic activities are undertaken to earn money. Generally people engage themselves in such activities on a regular basis and are said to be engaged in their occupation. Occupations may be classified into three broad categories. So when you talk about economic activities, the main motto is to earn money to fulfill their necessities and wants. Generally people engage themselves in such activities on a regular basis, because if they are going for a work or they are doing a business or any kind of category it will be, they will have to dedicate their time every day. Maximum in the 30 days, 26 days they have to dedicate and they have to work for it and are said to be engaged in occupation. Occupations may be classified into three categories. Let us understand. First is business. Business refers to an occupation in which goods and services are produced and sold in return of money. It is carried out on a regular basis with the prime objective of making profit. Mining, manufacturing, trading, transporting, storing, banking and insurance are examples of business activities. So we see some go on a normal work and some are having businesses. Now business is something where it refers to an occupation where goods and services have been produced, where the person makes, for example, let us take your books. Everybody cannot make books. Only a businessman who has got the license, they can produce the book, and these books are sold. In return, they will get money. And this is carried on a regular basis. If you see, books are available in various shops, stationeries, factories, or a wholesale rates also are there. So the prime objective here is to make profit. For example, if this book is costing, the entire book printing and everything takes around 200 rupees, but it is sold for 300 rupees, whereas it includes lot of things like storing, trading, transporting, all this all are different businesses. But to send one book from the producer to a student or the person who needs this book, lots of things are involved. So the costing will be 300, they will make it, so that 200 is the manufacturing cost, 100 rupees is the profit. So here the person who has produced the book is making profit of 100 rupees, or you can take it as 50 rupees also for the producer directly of this book. So some industries are mining, manufacturing, trading, transporting, storing, banking and insurance are some examples of businesses. The second is profession. When you talk about profession, it can be a skilled person. Like profession comes like doctor, engineer, nurses, consultant, teacher. These all are professionals. So they are profession based. A person may not be an expert in every field, so we require services of others who specialize in one field or other. For example, we need the services of doctor for our treatment, lawyers to get legal support, etc. They are all engaged in profession. So as I told you, profession is something a person is skilled in one particular work. Like doctor, he can take care of the patients to treat them. Lawyer can fight our cases if we are stuck in legal support if we require for that matters. So everybody cannot become or have the knowledge of all the category of the work. So we need a specialized person for one category of profession. Thus, profession refers to an occupation which requires specialized knowledge and training to pursue it, and primary object of every profession is to provide service. A professional body regulates every profession. These professionals have a code of conduct developed by the concerned professional body. So as I told you, everybody cannot get skilled in all the departments. So how we have doctors, we have lawyers, we have teachers, we have consultant, we have pilot, and so on. If we start with the count, we have got many people. So everybody is specialized and trained in their own industry. So they have the knowledge, they have been trained for that particular job constantly, which they keep repeating on a daily basis, and they improve their knowledge and their capability of handling situations and everything. So to run or head this particular professionals, there are certain professional body who regulates every profession. These professions have a code of conduct developed by concerned professional bodies. Next is employment. Employment refers to an occupation in which a person works regularly for another and gets wages, salary in return. Government servants, company executives, bank officials, factory workers are said to be in employment. In employment, there are certain terms and conditions regarding work to be performed, hours of work, amount of wages, salary and other facilities, if any. The employer who offers employment normally decides these conditions. The person seeking a job must join the work only after being satisfied with the terms and conditions. The remuneration payable to an employee is fixed and is paid in the form of wages or salary. So here, employment in the sense a person is having one particular office where he hires people and they have to work. For example, let us take bank. Now, when you go to bank, you see there are many people working in the bank. Why we are working? So that they can help us. A bank is a huge department where they can be called as government servants, company executives, factory workers. These are other professions. So example, if you take a bank, you can see many people are there, but everybody is not doing the same job. Different person is having different job. Now you see there is an accountant, then there is one person in the cash department, one is the manager, one is who is helping people in understanding or opening the account or closing the account. So many responsibilities are there for these people, and they have been hired by a particular bank. The head of the bank, you can call it as, for the branch, there is a manager who interviews a person, who decides his salary, who says what are the terms and conditions. Then the employer who offers them the employment, he is the one who is normally deciding all the conditions, like their timing, what is their salary and what kind of job they have to do. Everything is decided by the head of that particular branch. The person seeking a job must join the work only after being satisfied with the terms and conditions. So we cannot just go blindly tell, okay, I'll do. Before taking an offer from any department, you have to understand, like, what are the terms and conditions, and if you are happy working with the terms and conditions, then only you can do. The remuneration payable to an employee is fixed and is paid in the form of wage or salary to the person who is working for the bank. So now let us understand the difference between business, professional and employment. I'll just read out for you people, go through it carefully. First is nature of work. Nature of work, then we have qualification, then we have capital. So in business, supply of goods and services to the customer for money. Then qualification, no minimum qualification required. Capital, investment required according to the nature, size and scale of business. So nature of work in the sense what a business actually do it. That is, their main focus should be on supply of goods and services to the customers, that is for money. Second thing is qualification. There is no minimum qualification required to start a business. A person, what he needs is only the capital investment. Capital investment in the sense, if you want to start a business, you should have certain investment. Investment is, can be referred as money to start up, because he has to spend his money on buying a place, buying the furniture, hiring the employees to do that work and pay them the monthly salary, then to buy goods from outside, that's called as raw material, and so on, things are there. So they have to go according to that, and what is the size, what kind of business they want to do, and scale of business. Like if they are investing 1 lakh rupees, they have to have a particular margin to earn the profit also. Now let us see profession. Specialized personal service for and fee with discretion to work. So the person should be specialized for a particular amount to work as whatever profession he is going. Let that be a doctor, driver, conductor, pilot or anything, depending on what he has been specialized and been working for years. Education and training in a specific field is necessary. For example, he wants to become a doctor. MBBS is a minimum degree what he has to do. So that education should be related to that field only. Then only he will be able to work as a professional. Then limited capital required for establishment. So he doesn't have to spend much money on it. He has to just spend on his basic necessity to start his profession. But education is mandatory and must in that field. Employment, performing work according to the order of the employer with no discretion. So whatever the employer, the person who has hired him to work, they have to perform the duties according to the terms and conditions what the employer has made. Specialized knowledge, not necessary in all cases. Specialized knowledge should be there, but it depends on what industry it is and what kind of employment he is going for. And for this employment, there is no capital required. So he doesn't have to invest money, or he doesn't have to have any sort of calculations or calculations to have that he should have money to go ahead with it. Now, the fourth point here is motivation. Fifth point is risk. Sixth point is code of conduct. So in business, the motivation should be earning profits from scale of goods and providing services to the customers. So here the basic nature is the person should be able to earn profits from whatever goods he is making or selling and all those things to his customer. He has to keep a profit margin and then sell it to them. So risk, there is risk of loss, profits and uncertain. So every time whatever work they do, there will be a risk factor in all the fields. Let it be business, let it be profession, let it be employment. There will be a risk in every kind of business what a person does. So where the risk is about loss, in case what goods they have made, if it is not sold and if they are not able to earn the profit, so whatever investment what they have done, that will go for waste. Here in the business, code of conduct, no specific code of conduct is required in this. Now let us understand the profession. In the profession, motivation, motivation is fixed professional fees for service rendered. So whatever the person is, for example, if he is a doctor, there is a fixed salary for him. Like per month, this will be your withdrawal for the professionals. Then risk, fixed income, liability for negligence of duty. Since it will be a fixed income, that if he is not able to perform his duties or he is neglecting his duty, then he will have to face certain deduction in his salary. For example, if a basic salary is earning 10,000 rupees per month, and in case if he is not able to do his duty properly, if he is not able to go to his work on time, or if he is taking any holidays, leaves, that is, so in that 10,000 they will calculate and deduct his salary depending on how many number of leaves he has taken or how many number of the duty negligence he has done it. Now, code of conduct is a rigid professional code of conduct to maintain high standards of profession. So as I told you, being in a profession, he cannot neglect his duties. He has to be on time, he has to go for work on a daily basis. So this is a rigid professional code of conduct maintaining high standards of a profession. And in employment, fixed wages or salary. So when a person is an employee, also there will be a fixed wage or a salary which will be given to him. Risk, regular fixed wages or salaries, no risk. So there will be certain employments where if you are taking holidays also, there will be a fixed salary what they will be getting. So that particular salary will be given to them, and there is no such risk in this employment. Code of conduct, construction terms and conditions of employment. It depends on what kind of job he is doing. According to that, this can be constructual terms and conditions of employment. So he has to follow certain aspects of the contract. Contractual terms and conditions. So the person will be under a contract. So he has to follow that particular contract, and whatever the terms and conditions has been given in that contract, he has to follow that to have his employment in his hand. So for today's class, we will end here. In the next class, we will study meaning of business and what further we have in the business. Thank you.